This program includes mature subject matter. Parental discretion is advised.
This is something, too, they didn't talk about, whitelisting. And this is, again, we've had other whistleblowers. This is where Facebook allows popular leftist accounts, right, to just flagrantly disregard the rules, while, of course, they hold other accounts to the closest scrutiny or make up new rules, like with Donald Trump. We've had this on our Facebook page. We've talked about this. The Facebook page was throttled. It's considered misinformation or potentially damaging information, I believe, even though the information was not incorrect. It was quoting the CDC. The very same thing, by the way, has happened with YouTube. While we're talking about speaking before, you know, a Senate hearing, I think we have a clip of Ted Cruz talking about that. Why wasn't this being discussed from a whistleblower?
And I recount that because the YouTube CEO sat in my office and she admitted Stephen Crowder didn't violate any YouTube policies whatsoever. He was entirely consistent with their terms of service. But they nonetheless demonetized him anyway, simply shut off his ability to earn any revenue. And by the way, this is how the man earns his living. Demonetize. I ask everyone here to think how they would feel if some massive corporation demonetized you, just zeroed out your bank account. That is an incredible power. Well,
Susan Wojcicki was in his office talking about me?
What?
You have to tell me about this shit.
Come on, Ted. Make a phone call.
Your ears burning over there. Sorry.
He thought it was awesome. Clint Howard.
Yeah. By the way, lest you forget, our entire 2020 election stream was removed from Facebook. Gone. No reason still to this day. No reason given. Look, here's the thing. There are a lot of conservatives who have a victim complex and a persecution complex. Every time a tweet gets removed, when they say that we haven't broken any rules, but they create a new rule, which in the industry is known, colloquialism, as the Crowder rule that stings. And they have borderline guidelines. And some would argue that the Vox apocalypse, if you remember that happened. Alphabet stock took a nosedive because it affected not only us as creators. Then they came out and they had to say, well, actually, no rules were really broken. So they created a new set of rules that are entirely arbitrary and allow them to say, there's nothing inaccurate. There's nothing hateful. We're going to consider it borderline and just harm you anyways. Here's a video of Seth Meyers because no one watches it unless we force you to.
That's more offensive than anything you've ever said.
Yes,
Seth Meyers is autoplayed. But by the way, Facebook took down the largest live stream of the election, right? I think our numbers were just out of this world crazy. And it's like, oh, we can just stop that, right? You made a great point. Even if they put it right back up, you don't get those views back. People don't typically come back in. And they did it on the Oscar live stream when we were obviously doing parody.
Yeah.
Right? And it was fair use. They did it. They took it down. Up, we don't get it back. So that's the game they play.
I thought it was because when you called, I was in my basement and you called us and I called Gretchen Whitmer a bad name.
Oh, well, you know,
you guys beeped it.
Well, we're good.
I have no idea. I'm going to have to go back and review.
Yeah.
Thanks, Dave.
So if it was my fault, technically it wasn't your fault.
Nothing,
I was on a different show.
You are filled with nothing but verbal bile and actual bile. By the way, can someone get this bucket? It's starting to
smell. Yeah, it smells.
It's starting to smell like Wu-Tang Clan chowder.
There's heat off of it.
And this is something else. They didn't talk about Section 230. We've been talking about this on this show. Section 230 is a protection that's afforded to Facebook, YouTube, Twitter. What does it mean? It's very simple. Let me say, if you're talking on Verizon or AT&T, even if you're a Nazi talking about how you hate people of different races, which is horrible, it's abhorrent. But the fact is, they don't have the right to remove your cell service or stop your call. That's the same protection afforded to Facebook, YouTube, Twitter, because they're not liable for any comments or any content on that. That's not the same for the New York Times, Washington Post, because these are considered publishers. However, Facebook, when you clearly see they remove a sitting president, or Twitter removing a sitting president, and YouTube. By the way, you think that all happens at once by coincidence? Let's just be real. You don't think that, you don't think there was a meeting somewhere down the line that they remove him all within 24 hours of each other, and you still have the leaders of ISIS and Hamas out there for crying out loud? If we can't find common ground on the fact that people who throw gays off of rooftops are worse than the president of the United States, who gave an award to Boy George, then there's no common ground.
What award was that?
Yeah.
I don't know. He threw him off a roof before he could.
Oh, geez.
Yeah. Let's see. It's better than having wigs. Think of Santa, think of Trump.
Here's a golden trophy for vacuum mouth. I don't know if you guys heard Boy George, homosexual.
Yeah, homosexual guy.
These are things we can say on YouTube. They would be incorrect.
Yeah. Right? Yeah. I used to get to him confused with George Michael, and then I realized I wasn't getting him confused at all.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You could write the biography, and it would be very, very similar. You just add a couple of cornrows.
Yeah, just take the name out, put his name in.
Yeah. I'm going to change history and light in the world. She's from out of sight through my eyes. I'm going to lash back, check down, train to last a heart attack. Part of the ugliest lies. You can't convince me to change. We ain't on the same page. Oh, I had no feel. Now there's nothing but rage. Let's get out of my way, cause there's nothing to say. Is that all you get? Because I ain't got all day.
Hey guys, this is Amber. Hope you guys enjoyed the video. You can help out by hitting the like button and also sharing with your friends. Have you hit that subscribe button yet? If not, make sure you do so. And while you're there, go ahead and hit the bell notification so you can be the first to see all of the latest videos. Thanks for watching. See you guys next time. We got the freedom of speech until your ass gets shot. Where's the drive?